Talk about the stronghold of a real enemy. Doesn't look like it'll be an easy nut to crack.
Yeah, it seems like there's an awful lot of floors. Just stay calm and be careful drawing your map as you go.
It's probably safe to assume that the shadows are more powerful here. Can you handle it, Zen?
It won't be a problem. I've gained the abilities Ray had been using until now. I'll cause no trouble.
Huh? Don't tell me that's because of the power of love.
It would be more accurate to say I've regained them. Ray's battle abilities were originally my powers. She had the power to fight because I was with her, which means I was forcing her to fight. I've regained my memories as well as the power I lent her. I'll be able to fill Ray's role from now on. I'll make sure not to drag you down. So...
just remember to not push yourself too hard. There's no shame in relying on one's companions.
Yes, I understand. Thank you.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, everyone. I'm sorry, Zen. This is all because I was selfish.
Rachel, she's suffering.
The meaning of life. Who would have that answer?
Why does one need a reason? They're living now and existing here. That is life. It doesn't matter if there is meaning behind it or not.
Maybe not, but...
that's what I thought. Until I met Ray. Now I don't know anymore.
It's not a matter of whether the meaning exists or not. The search for meaning is universal, regardless.
The search for meaning? You seek some justification for your existence?
Yeah, from someone. Possible from someone important.
Why? You're already alive. You don't need any justification for that.
Day to day by supporting, cooperating, and encouraging each other. When things are tough, and we're lonely or down, we remember friendly faces. That's how we can bear it.
Indeed. Because those precious to me are doing their best, I feel that I can do the same. I believe no one lives their life alone.
Alone?
Don't worry, I'm here with you. You're not alone.
Not alone.
The time has come. The time for you all to carry out your duties.
That sound, it's the Reaper.
Oh crap, that strong as hell monster?
Why? Of course. I'm only one of the many cogs in this machine. That's why this world is after me.
Wait, what? What do you mean?
There is something called natural providence in the world. It is the force that maintains balance. Even Kronos is under its control. I locked myself here and sealed away my powers. As a result, a life that should have returned, Ray's soul, is not returning to where it should. That endangers the balance. If it were to happen, it would eventually lead to this world's destruction. Thus, the sealed-off Kronos was made to awaken before that could occur. The countdown had begun the moment I locked myself in here. And that hour has now struck. The time for this haven in the rift to disappear.
Disappear, huh?
Huh?
Wait, so what's gonna happen to us? Or you? for Rachon.
We'll disappear too. Everything. Including our very existence. To compensate, none of you or Rey would have existed from the start. The scales would thus be balanced. No one will remember that any of you were ever alive.
We never have existed.
That's correct. It will be made so that you were never born to begin with.
What?
It's still not too late. You need to head back and return to your own times through those doors. Do that, and you'll be...
Even if we're safe, what about Rayson? She said she wanted a reason to be alive, but to retroactively erase her existence? That's too cruel.
But...
What'll happen if the sealed Kronos wakes up?
He'll assimilate me. He'll return to his original complete state and erase this world along with Rey. That's why he's suspended Rey where she is. He wishes to lure me to where he is in this clock tower. That spider isn't a shadow from the school. It's one of Kronos' minions. And all of you were also bait.
Bait?
Kronos was the one who summoned you from your original worlds. He did it to make me traverse the labyrinths, so that I would regain my memories. Kronos chose you all because you had the power to accomplish this.
I see. So we were pawns who dutifully played our role perfectly. But are we still pawns?
Huh?
Is us traveling with you to where Kronos waits part of his plan, too?
No. I doubt it. When my memories returned, I was supposed to erase Rey and this world.
But you haven't done that, right?
No. Changed? Me?
You've changed, but you may not realize it. That alone means there's a wrench in Kronos' plan.
To hell with that guy acting all high and mighty like a god.
I don't really get it, but we just have to beat him and it's done, right?
Right. The option of backing down never entered our minds.
Everyone.
Even if us coming here was part of someone's grand plan, it doesn't matter. I'm glad we came. I've gained tons more companions, for one thing.
Yeah, there's no need for you to feel responsible after all we've been through, Zenkun.
Zenkun, what you must do hasn't changed. Please speak to Rayson.
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Woohoo! This bear's gonna bust out my special owl punches!
A bear? And also an owl?
Teddy, are you going to become an owl bear?
Whoa, what are you talking about?
Hey, what do you think about Kanji? Dude, why are you backing away from me? I didn't mean it in a weird way, you moron! I was just thinking that I learned a lot from him during this. You heard what he said to Ken, right? He said you're free to think what you want. No one has the answers for you, so think for yourself. No matter how much oppression he's facing, he always does his best to stand up against it by himself. I felt like what he said to Ken really got across that true inner strength of his. I didn't know he always thought about things that way. Then again, it's not just Kanji. Risei and Naoto are younger too, but I feel like they're way stronger than me. Chie and Yukiko never back down from what they believe in. And whatever Teddy says, he's a good guy. After he heard about Rei-chan, he was off crying by himself. Risei, what are you crying for?
It's the way you're saying this. It's all wrong.
Hey, that's mean.
I don't want you saying such nice things. I don't like it because it sounds like you're about to die.
Huh? Sorry, that's not how I meant it.
You gotta be laughing like an idiot all the time, Yosuke-senpai. It helps everyone relax when they hear you laughing things off. That's why, when things are no laughing matter, you need to keep laughing like an idiot. Then we can all do our best. So you can laugh like an idiot from the bottom of your heart.
Right. By the way, you're leaning pretty hard on the laugh like an idiot thing. I'm not that reckless. Hello?
Damn it, she cut the comm off. Hey, partner, is she right about me always laughing like an idiot? What? Hey, do you understand the idea of context? Where the hell did that come from? Man, Reese is such a nice girl. She's got a keen eye, but you don't get nervous when she trains it on you. Hey, maybe what's good about me is that I'm blessed with the friends I have. Huh? Well, I mean, it's kind of tough saying it to your face. I can't say stuff like how you're reliable and cool and great at playing along, you know? Anyway, I'm gonna do my best to be someone I can be proud of around those guys. Let's go, partner.
The culture festival here was an imaginary world that Rae-chan wished for, right? I can kind of understand Rae-chan's desire to make this place. Going somewhere that's not real, hoping someone will save you. I wanted that for a long time, too.
Yukiko!
The meaning of life and death are too heavy for me. I didn't know what I could say to help her. But I refused to believe there was no meaning in Rae-chan's life. Everyone helped me out, and I want to repay that by helping Rae-chan out when she's sad. Then again, I guess it's presumptuous to say this when I always need help from you, Chie.
Hey, that's not true. I think you're plenty strong, Yukiko. You've helped me out, too.
Huh?
I really can't deal with scary stuff. Remember how I flipped out about that FOE in the haunted house? It was so dark that I couldn't see anything, and I was so scared that I seriously thought I might die. But you took my hand and guided me, Yukiko.
Oh, no, that wasn't anything much.
It was to me. If you hadn't taken my hand, I don't think I could have walked a single step.
Chie, so there are ways that even I can protect you.
There's tons of stuff like that. You help me out with stuff I'm bad at, and I help you out when you're in trouble. I think that's the way to go. I wanted to always look out for you, but I realized it's nice to have someone looking out for me, too. Yep, that's what friends are for. It's not about one side protecting or being protected. I guess you call it an even footing. Of course, I still want to look out for Yukiko and everyone. That won't change. But I want to trust more that they're looking out for me, too.
Chie, I feel like you've matured.
Huh? Really?
Mm-hmm. And maybe I have, too. Not long ago, I wouldn't have wanted you to change. I would have been lonely if you did. But now, it makes me happy. Everyone slowly changes, but that just means we're growing. I want to grow together with everyone and be at their sides to see how they change.
In that case, I hope we stay friends forever and ever.
Mm-hmm, me too.
Well then, let's get started putting our efforts together. Time to go save Rae-chan! Yeah!
This may be impolitic to say, given Zenkun and Rae-san's circumstances, but I took away a great deal from meeting the Gekkoukan High students. It surprised me to learn that the Kirijo group had been pursuing the apathy syndrome case in secret. But what made a stronger impact on me was the way Mitsuru-san took command of the situation.
It's true! That sultry, mature aura pouring off of Mitchan made quite an impact on me, too!
No, I meant her mindset, her whole approach to life. Though we are about the same age, she's trying to accomplish something great through her own convictions. Not only that, she's doing it as a woman. The oppression I felt when dealing with the police is minuscule compared to what she's facing. you think so? I hope that's the case. Thank you, Senpai. You're always so kind. But meeting Mitsura-san threw my own naivete into sharp relief. Acting tough because I don't want to be treated lightly as a woman. In a way, that was only an excuse of mine. I resisted more than necessary because part of me thought it's only natural for women to be treated lightly. I'd said some things to Kanji-kun at the Inaba Pride exhibit about not forcing himself into a box. But actually, I sensed something amiss within me. Though of course I felt that way. My view of myself was more biased than anyone else's after all. What happened here was a good opportunity to realize that aspect of myself exists. Even though it may only be a little at a time, I hope to continue changing from here on.
Even though Michan is a superwoman, sometimes she pushes herself too hard. She seems like she's gonna get crushed by her burdens. And it's sad to watch.
Teddy. More kind-hearted than I had expected.
You didn't need to add that last part. I think about things too, you know. Even I have something to say.
Is that so?
I have decided at this moment that I am going to graduate from being merely an adorable bear.
Well then, we should get going.
Wait, at least hear me out. I was only an adorable mascot until now. But I've started to think that's not enough. That's why I've decided to make myself a manly mascot, too.
Is this Koromaru-kun's influence I detect?
Oh, I was hoping no one would notice. But that's right. To be honest, I didn't think much of him at first. I thought he was just an ordinary mutt. But how would an ordinary mutt be that good at seizing the girls' hearts? What I finally figured out is, it's his manliness!
That reminds me. When you almost failed to escape the bathroom, it was him who dragged you to safety.
That's right. It made even my heart skip a beat. Anyway, if I can be adorable and manly, it'll be an invincible combo to drive the girls wild!
Your questionable objective aside, I think it's a good thing that you're trying to grow. We can thank our meeting with those who gave us this opportunity for that. Why are you saying that to me? Or do you mean to say something in you has changed because of me? I suppose that could be possible. We're so close to each other. So it stands to reason we affect each other as well.
So I'm gonna continue staying at Yosuke's place and honing my teddiness. I won't rest until I've reached the rank of meat director at Juness!
Oh, so you're not aiming to become completely independent. Ah, I'm sorry. I was explaining the gimmick from before.
Gimmick?
I know what that is. It's a fake treasure box.
That's a mimic.
I knew that.
A gimmick is the secret to how something works. There was a time I was a bit into, magic tricks, which is where I learned the word.
Magic tricks? Wow, that's cool. Can you show us one?
Huh? That's...
I can do one! One, a two, and a three! Presto! Really? I'm amazing?
This guy's ego is only the size of a house because you keep feeding it.
Naoto-kun really is good with her hands, though. She changed my watch battery and even fixed my umbrella.
You can say the same thing about Kanji, then. Have you ever seen his knitted dolls? Even their clothes are handmade. It's some next-level work.
Though they are impressive, I guess.
Thinking about it that way, Naoto-kun and Kanji-kun might have a lot in common.
No way!
No way! Wait, actually...
Uh-huh.
Kanji-kun and myself are...
A
I think I get it. They're good with their hands, but totally awkward in every other way.
Every other way?
Mm-hmm, that's right. You two are very similar.
But, well, that's... I doubt Naoto would agree.
On the contrary, I can't tell for myself. But if everyone else says so, who am I to argue? When I'm with you all, I always see a different side of myself. And somehow, it's never as distasteful as I might expect. It's quite mysterious.
Hmm?
I don't think it's so strange. That's what being companions is all about.
It is?
I don't think just getting along and having conversations makes you companions. Then again, just gathering for a common goal doesn't seem to do the trick either.
Wait, you don't get it either?
What makes people companions varies from person to person, no? For me, companions are the ones who help to pull me up. That's why I try to be someone who can pull everyone else up, too.
Yosuke-senpai.
If you find something about yourself that you like, isn't that because you have companions with you? You wouldn't ever find anything new about yourself alone, after all.
Which means everyone else is causing changes in me. Seeing it that way is exciting. Makes me wonder how I've changed and how I might continue to do so. Yes, I look forward to watching you change as well, Senpai.
You are alive. That's why you can change.
Zen-kun?
Change is such a beautiful thing.
Yes, I believe so as well. Life is beautiful.
We should get going again. Rei-chan's waiting for us.
Yes!
Hold on, Senpai. I think it's the next floor up. I'm getting a reading of that spider-like shadow.
So, above us is the top of the tower.
What's wrong?
I was thinking about what to say to Rei. Will I be able to give her a reason why she lived? I've never lived myself. Do I even have the correct answer?
Yeah, I think so too. I don't think what you say is what matters. It's your feelings that go into it.
Feelings?
Come on, you're not trying to get across any particular words, but how you feel. If you feel Rei is important to you, then it doesn't matter what words you use to say it. That's something I learned from Yukiko-senpai and the others.
My feelings. After watching you all here, I've come to understand something. To live is to change. Your encounters with others changes you. This is true for Kanji, Ken, and even myself. We all changed because we met each other.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Even the smallest interaction is part of a great flow passed from person to person. We all affect each other, and things change naturally. That is how the world works, which means one's life is not merely one's own problem. Living changes those around you, who in turn change you. That's why one's life is by no means only your own.
Your life isn't just your own.
Rei cried because she wanted meaning in her life. I couldn't give her that, but I see it differently now. The fact that Rei lived was itself the meaning in her life. To live is the duty of those who are given life. What do you think? This is just what I think. It's not the only answer, I am sure. But if you agree, then I feel as if I've been saved. I wonder why. I believe that there is a meaning for everyone. You've changed someone too. You're being kept alive by someone else. I choose to believe that this is the reason why you've lived. Then again, I shouldn't arbitrarily decide your meaning for you. Thank you. I must have been the one who called you here. Not as Kronos' pawns, but to help me. This is what I believe. Had I not met you, I couldn't have realized my own weakness, or truly saved Rey. Meeting you all was my destiny, and my salvation.
Dude, you've become a real man.
A real man? I don't understand, but I like the sound of it.
There it is.
I'm getting a strong reading. It's powerful, so be careful. Rayshon is inside that shadow.
Hey, Rayshon!
Rayshon, please answer us.
Wake up!
It's no use. Rayshon's reading is still weak.
Then we have to hurry and defeat it. Enough talk. Come at us.
Rey, we'll save you. Not with my power alone, but with everyone's. Through all of our strengths combined, we'll save you!
We've gotta save Rayshon! Let's do it, no matter what!
My turn now.
Here I go.
Crush him, caster.
Easy.
I think you have to hit its head.
I understand. I'll aim for that. Can't hit its head like this.
Protect them, Kanzeon!
Are you ready?
Izanagi no Okami!
It's all mine!
Thank you.
Messiah!
Yamato the Carrier!
Perfect timing. It won't. I'll show you my resolve. A persistent adversary.
Oh! The leg disappeared! There's two legs left!
Understood. Which one next?
Are you ready?
Messiah!
Take this! Tsunagi no Oka!
Take this!
We can all attack! Charging in!
Are you ready?
I'm counting on you, Messiah.
Izanagi no Okami!
Here goes.
Go! Yamato the Karu!
Persona!
Izanagi no Okami!
I'm counting on you, Messiah!
Here goes!
Come, Yamato the Karu!
Rei, are you all right?
Zen? Thank goodness! Are you okay? Can you walk?
No.
You can't? Here, take my hand!
Run. Please. Run!
Huh? Be careful! Something's coming!
been a while.
I am Kronos, creator and king of time. Time to reap the seeds I have sown has come.
This is the personification of my power as Kronos, an unfeeling god that only obeys its duty and reaps what time is left. This was me before I met Rey. It will be powerful, tremendously so.
Powerful? Don't make me laugh.
We ain't turning tail and running after making it this far.
I don't care if you're a god or what. I'm gonna leave footprints all over you.
Mm-hmm. That goes double for me.
I won't back down either. For Rayson, for Zen-kun, for all of us.
Rayson, just hang in there. We'll save you soon enough.
Everyone. Companions. I'm weak, but that weakness has taught me much. That I've been running away. That it's my companions who support me, the feelings I believe in, and what I wish to protect. Our enemy now is the me that used to run away. I will defeat myself!
You, who were once part of me, return to me. Otherwise, you shall return to the embrace of eternity.
Here it comes! You have to win this, no matter what! No, seriously, whatever it takes, save Rayson!
Forgive me, for I was not able to save you back then. Forgive me for saving you now.
Let's go!
Let's put an end to this.
Cover me!
Take this! Izanagi no Okami!
I'll go.
Here I go!
Blast them, caster!
What was that? There's a weird counter on Senpai!
That's the gear of life. It counts down and claims your life when it reaches zero.
No! Isn't there anything we can do?
Revival skills or items can prolong the counter, but it cannot be completely removed until it claims you.
We've got to pay attention to those counters, not just our health.
He governs death and time. Be careful.
Are you ready? Come! I'm counting on you, Messiah.
Makisu Izanagi!
Are you all right?
Go! Yamato Takeru! Yamato Takeru!
eat.
This world is too easy.
Too easy.
Bro, your attack power is lower right now.
Next up, Caster!
Kaguya! Take this! Izanagi no Oka!
Here, have this.
Persona!
Are you ready?
Izanagi no Okami!
I'm using this. Are you all right?
By all means, use this.
Are you all right?
Here I go.
Vice Leader's number went down to one!
I'm already at one.
Are you ready?
Come! All right.
Marcus Luis and I!
There.
Please, don't strain yourself.
Come, Kanzeon!
using this.
Come, Messiah!
Izanagi no Okami!
There.
Here I go.
Is already at one.
Persona!
Hey, shit! Izanagi no Okami!
Huh. I'm using this.
I'm using this.
To live.
Persona!
Hey, shit! Izanagi no Okami!
Are you all right?
Hang in there.
We've changed too. Zenkun, Rei-chan, everyone from Yasogami High, they've all become precious to us.
That's right. That's why we're here. Rei-chan and Zenkun are one of us!
Meeting them has changed us, and vice versa. That's what life is about.
There you have it. I don't let anyone who messes with my companions off lightly. That's why I'm fighting you.
You've also changed by coming to this world. That is why we stand here, and that is why we will fight you.
Kronos, do you understand what you were lacking? I didn't have it until now either. The power in a fleeting life. The beauty it holds. You see? They have taught me much. And so, I am here to defeat you and negate myself. I will save Rei. That is the duty I have undertaken. Of my own will.
Ridiculous counter!
Are you ready?
Marcus to Izanagi!
Must return from whence you came.
Time.